Hello, hello, and welcome everyone to Kylie's first official roast. You know, it's kind of funny how they're having a roast considering the views on episode 3 was probably good enough.
Hi.
Hi, Lulu.
Hola, chica.
Now, you usually go by Miss Doodoo, but I think we can all agree after being in this competition with you, we'll all be calling you Miss DeLulu.
Oh.
And I must say, I really admire how Lulu always incorporates a symbolic side piece with all of her looks. Her trusty bald spot.
Oh. The bald spot.
No, ma'am.
Now, let's all take 15 seconds to Google who Becky Pink is.
Who?
It says something about working for ReelTV, when the only thing about her that is real is the awkward silence in the workroom when we found out she was judging. On to our next bitch of the day. Star, my lovely, sweet drag mother. You know, I have a lot of siblings, and it really shows how good of a mother Star is. That's until we get to Alicia. Alicia, now, before she walks out again, let me say this. I liked it better when her name was Alicia's son, because at least the son goes away.
Oh.
And how could I possibly forget my good Judy Aubert? Hi, Aubert.
Hello.
You know, Aubert loves to call herself the camp diva, which truly does define you. Because when I go camping, I usually end up looking like shit as well. As you may know, Aubert and I go way back. We were both doing different things that we would never do today. I was in my Miss Congeniality era, and she was in her winter era.
Oh my God.
And in the great words of Melinda, you're a bitch! Oh
my gosh.
Jesus.
Oh wait, I missed a girl? Oh yeah. Asteria, you're still here? You know, Asteria is the only queen in history to be out lip-synced by a bitch who walked out of the building. Baby, your supernova lacked the super. Now onto the head bitch herself. Hi, Kylie.
Hi.
You know, Kylie is known for her recycling skills in road drag. So, Kylie, I have one question for you. How much of your look did you make today?
No comment.
Oh, girl.
None of it.
Sorry. Well, thank you all for listening to my set. If you liked it, I'll be signing t-shirts in the parking lot. And Kylie will be there trying to import more outfits from The Sims.
Oh.
Have a good night, everyone.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Lulu doo-doo.
Oh. Hey.
Hey.
Hey, girl. How you doing?
Hey, girl. Good.
I sure hope so. But, wow, can we all just congratulate Beach for what a journey that was. Like, come on now. A round of applause, please. Or not. Oh, okay. We got some claps. Thank you. So, Beach. Well, bitch, tell me how you excel at every comedy challenge. Like, you are so talented, but the talent sadly stops there, as we see in your runways.
Oh, bitch! Hold on. Oh, bitch!
Moving on to someone who is not a stranger to being in the bottom, Asteria. How are you, queen?
Ice crack.
You know, I thought we were similar because, you know, the first week I thought you were, you know, you were a little pretty until I realized that your sense and fashion isn't on the same page.
Oh.
But besides that, how did you get outshined in lip sync by a bitch who didn't even lip sync? Oh. Alicia tore your ass up, did she not? Well, she did. Now, to my favorite crayon, Aubert. How are you, queen?
I'm good.
You know, besides Beach, I feel like you are the funniest bitch in the building, you know? actually, except for last week, where was that humor? Let's get to the judges panel. So first we have the bitch in the pink wig. Sorry, what's your name again? Actually, don't even say it. I don't really care. But, you know, I didn't know you at all. Like, all I knew is that you were from, like, ReelTV or something. But now that I look at you and, like, what's behind the panel, I know where you're from. Your pussy was featured in the Muppets as Kermit. We love a fungus queen.
No.
Not
the fungus.
Let's go to Star Star. You know, you are not similar to your drag daughters. It's weird because a lot of your drag daughters are like really, really, really ugly, you know? They bring horrible runways and I'm not including myself, y'all. I need to set the fuck down. But speaking of bad runways, can we think about Beach's flower runway real quick?
Bitch, I won.
Girl, your runway flop. And what about it? Well, besides that, let's move on to the queen of lag, Miss Ivory. You know, a lot of people look up to your drag, and I don't think they would look up to you anymore if they realized how laggy your looks were. You know, I recall a specific time when you put on your morph, and the game was so laggy, I couldn't tell if Kylie was taking a massive shit or if my rattle shut down.
Okay.
And speaking of the girl herself, speaking of Kylie, I feel like we all have come to the conclusions that your runways, anyway, you have referenced a lot in your runways, you know, like your last runway, it gave me very much emo girl from Encanto. Like, you look like the bitch with flowers from Encanto, but like emo, you know, like it was serving, I'm in love with an emo girl, you know?
Okay.
But besides the emo comment, let's introduce the unfunny bitch besides myself, Asteria.
Yes!
Hey, let's get this show on the road. Hi there. I would just like to start by just thanking Lulu for that marvelous introduction. Now we won't be talking about your bald spot, but that performance.
Oh!
Die.
The only thing that is stopping from Lulu from grading the crown is her hairline.
Oh. I'll do it.
As you all may know, I don't have a win, so that technically puts me in runner up for not winning the crown.
Yeah.
Woohoo!
So now we have Becky Pink here, y'all, and not Becky with the good hair.
Oh!
Hey, Ivory. You look good tonight. I love how you did a recreation of Simone's train runway, but there's a difference in that. She won $100,000 and you just won 3 crown meshes. Hi, Kylie.
Hi.
As you know, you're, of course, the main host. And first of all, I just want to thank you for opening the doors to all the have detailed looks that minor queens present in every long term.
Woo! Okay.
Kylie is so tall that production had to cut the stage in half. So she just had to stand up and look nice.
Tall, bitch.
Thank you for having me tonight, and I'll just like to present our next roaster, you would say, Albert.
Yes.
Ooh, oh lord. Let's just have a breather for that performance by Asteria. Lord, hello. Anyways, Asteria really gave it her all, didn't she? She at least deserves a clap. So let's give a clap. No, do not clap. She doesn't deserve it, actually. She does not. Oh. After that 5-second performance, she does not deserve anything. But it's so nice and lovely to be surrounded by such amazing drag artists and hysteria. Speaking of hysteria, I was in the bottom three last week, Safe Flow, which hysteria would also call home.
Oh my god.
Hysteria hysteria is a lovely reminder that there is always a pleasure in being in the bottom.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
But now that we've established that hysteria is the Roxy of the season, like always in the bottom. Now, just like Roxy, I really do wish you was left at the bus stop. So we can see the whole performance you have every week. Too far. Is that too far? I mean, I wouldn't worry because it's the exact same thought I had of hysteria making it past episode 3. Too far. But really, she probably has amazing runways every week. I don't know what they look like because she's faded. And just like that, she's gone. Speaking of fading, Beach, how are you, girl?
I'm good.
I don't care. Anyways, just like Beach. Just like Beach. You make me nauseous, irritated, and you let everybody walk all over you. But that is way too easy. So let me do a demonstration. Beach, come on stage for me. Beach, come on stage. Get up here. Hurry it up. Now, no, not too close. Step back a little bit. Now, can you go to the far left for me? Over to the far left of that stage. Into the corner. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Right to the edge. Keep going. Right, that works. Now, for everybody else... For everybody else, everyone, we're going to have to prepare for this. Everyone take a deep breath in. Can everybody else notice that the horrid smell is gone? The horrid smell is gone. That horrid and disgusting smell is gone.
Oh my god.
And now we finally know that that southern accent that Beach abuses finally fits. But, Beach, just stay there for me, girl. You recently came out as non-binary, and I could not be more proud of you. And now let's be respectful and go on a pronoun check. Beach goes by they, them, which is absolutely amazing. And Lulu goes by he, him out of drag and she, her in drag. Wait, hang on. I feel like I made a mistake. Lulu, please correct us on what your pronouns are. Wait. Don't bother, I've just remembered. Lulu's pronouns are next out, judging by that roast performance.
No.
Okay, Beach, you can go sit back down. You can go and sit back down. Everyone, hold your breath quickly. We've had our one moment of glory of fresh air. Which leads me on to Lulu. RuPaul says that we as gay people, we get to choose our family. Which I think it's a statement that was said. Now, Lulu, is that statement true with ogres, or do you have a different way of family working? I'm unaware. Because, sweetheart, Shrek doesn't need the free publicity with your workroom entrance outfits. They have 4 movies already.
Oh my god.
But Lulu, I'm going to be honest with you, girl. Lulu, I'm going to be honest with you, girl. I'm really struggling on which roast to use for you. Not because I love you, no. Because they're so bad and nobody will get them. Which I guess has a strong relation to your runways every single week.
Dang. No.
Now it does say a lot that your bald spot has been more memorable than your entire storyline with a person that we shall not name. Wow. I'm not going there because even I don't remember that.
Oh.
But just like that storyline, we will be moving swiftly on.
Oh god.
Now, Star. You're named after stars and whatever. Am I correct? Yes, I don't care what you have to say either. And then I think the name really fits. Because just like a star, I am so glad you're so far away and you have zero personality. But there is one thing that doesn't fit with your drag name. Unlike a star, you're not very bright.
Oh my god.
Now, Becky Pink. I have no idea who you are, but judging by that judging outfit, just no.
Oh.
No. Now, Kylie. Hi, sweetheart. What did you say? Okay, it doesn't matter. Now, Kylie.
Hi. Yes, hello.
Hi, sweetheart. How are you?
Oh, I'm great.
Lovely, lovely. I don't care either. Oh. I don't care either.
Okay.
Now, Kylie, you told the cast not to attack you personally. And I think that is so hypocritical of you. Because have we seen your runways this season? That's not only an attack on you, but on yourself, but the entire drag community as a whole.
Oh,
but Kylie is so ugly that not even Lulu tried to date her. And Lulu tried to date Leon.
Leon is bae.
Next.
Now, Kylie, please look at me. And I'm going to be very emotional with you now. I'm going to mean every word I say. I'm going to get a bit emotional because I mean, it's just personal to me, but you should really let someone who's good at drag host season 2. Good. That is all that I have for tonight.
Oh,
it's
God.
Been lovely having you all. If you hated me, I didn't give a fuck. Goodbye.
Oh my gosh.
Yes.
What the fuck?
Oh my fucking God. The world is your runway.
We'll be right back.